to get money out when I get there, but what is okay to carry around with you or an issue?
All right, for carrying money, I always recommend, I don't know what you've been telling me as far as different locations going to have different scenarios. When I went to Korea, I ran into the fact that I only took a little bit with me, and I didn't have any more, and so then I had to try to find a bank or ATM. If you have to go to an ATM, go to large, well-known banks.
With at least two people.
At least two people.
Do not go to an ATM alone.
Do not go to an ATM alone. That any event you do run out of money. I always recommend not putting more than all your money in one place. I always have at least 100, some people say 300, and you put it to the inside of your waistband or to somewhere inside. So even if somebody does steal your wallet or your luggage gets lost, or maybe you get where you're going and thieves just ransack the night, you're not completely broke now. You know what I mean? You have an emergency fund. I like doing the prepaid Visa cards because it's not attached to any of your personal banking information, and they can get preloaded like $200. Mm-hmm. So now you have a credit card that if somebody does steal your information, no big deal. You're not completely.
And it's only got a limited amount.
Yeah, it's got a limited amount. Good question. Do you have recommendations, or is it area specific?
A lot of it is area specific. The one about having it in various locations, especially those of you on short-term travel, I like to have money in three locations on my body. And you can be creative about that. The inside, as he was talking about, those inside pockets that you use for your passport, those are great for money too.
Mm-hmm.
Waist ones are great, they can go inside your pants. There are waist wallets that can hang on a belt. That hang inside, it's kind of harder if you're a girl and don't have a belt. You can use your bra. You can use socks, although some of you are going to be in hot countries, but I've put money in socks before. Shoe, not so much because it can kind of come out of your shoe. But have always have some, and part of that is if you get robbed openly, if somebody comes and robs you and says, give me your money, you can give them one portion of that, you know. Get it from a typical location and just say, this is what I have.
Mm-hmm.
This is all I have in my pocket.
Here, take my whole wallet.
And
now we're dying of it.
And so that's, you know, carrying money in several locations and not carrying everything. But again, it's just like your passport. If you're taking a lot of money in, you're not going to leave that. Don't leave anything of value in a suitcase in a hotel room. That's a rule of thumb that is just really important. Some nicer hotels do have room safes. Those can be safe. Make sure that it can't be carried. A lot of third world countries have very small safes that aren't attached to the wall and can just be taken out of the room. And so, you know, trust your providers. If the hotel front desk isn't maybe safe, they may be able to tell you, don't leave anything at the front desk. Those are the things that your provider is going to be very key wherever you are in the country or your travel leader in telling you how to, especially cash. And some places aren't going to have ATMs. Some places you aren't going to be able to use Visa cards. Some places you have to use the, I think especially in Europe, now you all have to have a chip. So if you're planning to use your card, make sure your card has a chip in it. You can just go to your bank or your credit union and get those before you go. Those are very key. Your trip leader, if you're going with a trip leader, should have enough cash for the essentials. So your money is just going to be for non-essentials.
Exit pass. Somebody tell me one thing they learned today. Can't do it until somebody tells me one thing they learned today. Something new. I gotta hear something. Yes, ma'am.
The idea of a prepaid visa is really smart. I've never heard that before.
Ah, okay. Mm-hmm. Anyone else? Anyone learn anything new today?
Yes, I would like to carry the cup as a passport.
Having different places, you don't have to take the original or anything. I love it. All right. Well, thank you all for having me. Okay.